Hello guys, today I want to review a package, Livewire package called Livewire Calendar. So this calendar with drag and drop possibility. And it's created by this guy, Andres Santibanez. He's pretty active generally on GitHub with Livewire specifically, so you can check his other repos. But today we'll be creating a calendar for a project based on our quick admin panel generator with Tailwind in Livewire. We have the version 4 Livewire, but in that version we used to use full calendar JavaScript library, fullcalendar.io, and I thought, why not change the JavaScript to Livewire? And I will demonstrate you that in this video. It's not specifically for Quick Admin Panel, it's just a demonstration of how that Livewire package works with this core generated code. So the code before that Livewire was like this. So this is Livewire part, I will show you that in a minute. So it was div id calendar, and then at the bottom JavaScript code to load the events, and the events come from the controller, task calendar controller, like this. So get all the tasks with mapping them with the collection method and then returning title, start and URL. And the installation is really simple. So I've installed Livewire calendar. Then there's no config required. You just need to make a component which extends not the component of Livewire, but Livewire calendar. Just changing the extends part. So here's the component, class task calendar extends Livewire calendar, then add this on top, and then all you need to do is return the events in a collection, which is roughly similar collection to what was in my controller here, but just with a different keys of the array. So there should be ID, title, description, and date. And that's it. Then in your blade, wherever you want, you just load Livewire task calendar. And here's the visual result in comparison. So this was full calendar, and this is the calendar powered by Livewire. As you can see, there's no CSS styles here. And because inside of the Quick Admin Panel Generator code, we use purging and with Tailwind config, we don't have the CSS styles from that package. We need to add that package folder here in the content. So here I've done exactly that. So third array item is the vendor folder of resources views. It's one way of doing that. There are other ways. And if you want to know more about why it's purging and how does it all work, I have a separate video on our Quick Admin Panel channel about purging with Tailwind in this specific scenario. But this will give us the actual styling. So if we rerun npm run dev, so the CSS was 92.4 kilobytes, now it's 93. And if we refresh the page with full refresh of the CSS, now we have the styling. And now we can also drag drop the events. So for example, I drag the event from the 24th to the 16th, and it is saved in the database. For that, I added this code. This is where Livewire solution shines over JavaScript. So if you prefer the backend, the Laravel, the PHP code, all you need to do is work with Livewire functions. For example, on event click is like this, and on event dropped, drag dropped, you have the parameters, and then all you need to do is do update on whatever you want with the data that you have. The only downside of that calendar, Livewire calendar, that it doesn't contain those buttons. So November 2021 and those buttons come from the JavaScript. And this calendar is actually monthly calendar of current specific month. So you would need to build those buttons yourself. And I will try to do that. I won't build that in full, but I will show you the principle. So in the index blade, let's remove that div id calendar. And for task calendar, you can provide parameters of, here we go in the docs, there's before calendar view and after calendar view. So before calendar view should be another file, the blade file. And let's try to add that. Before calendar view would be, for example, calendar before. And let's create resources views, new file, calendar slash before.blade.php. And let's put anything here for now. So in the index, we reference that, and let's just reload the page to see if it's actually loaded. So refresh the page. There's no old calendar and there's before. So here you should build the buttons for navigation between the months. And I haven't found the actual documentation on how to do that, but the clues could be found in the Livewire component itself. So if it extends Livewire calendar, if we click and go inside of that Livewire calendar, which is in vendor, there are public properties that you can play around with. So for example, we have starts at and ends at, which means current month, first date and last date. So for example, you can play around with, if we open before blade, let's change the before to H2, for example, with class tailwind text to Excel, for example. And let's add this. starts at, and this is a carbon object, to format which month it is. So month and year, I think that is the syntax. And now if we refresh our page, we have November 2021. So with that, you can build the links to change the starts at and reload the component changing those properties, which are all public, and you can use them in your Blade files. So that's it, a quick review. What do you think? Would you use that calendar, or have you maybe? What is your impression? And if you want more components of Livewire, I have my own library called livewirekit.com, which is currently 33 Livewire components on various topics that I gathered over browsing over internet from your comments and from your ideas. So you can get all those components all in one for $29 at the moment. It's not a recurring price, it's just one-time price, and it will get you the access to the repository, and you will get more components with time without paying extra money. It's within the same $29. And by purchasing Livewire Kit, you support this YouTube channel, because then I have more free time to shoot free videos for here on YouTube. That's it for this time, and see you guys in other videos.